learned from the lesson. Live in the hills, but I still get a spread. Started with a lil, but I still reinvest it. Fear how I feel, then you feel less a blessing. I just want the lesson, I just want protection. I'm up and I'm down, but they sound like progression. Farmer never plans if he waits for perfection. Finger to the down, hold it down, we gon' get it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I got your watchlist coming in on May 1st, 2020, and the stock market is disappointed. Despite this being one of the best months at the end of this since, I think, 1987, we've seen a pretty big rally. However, earnings, and now we got some of the big companies like Apple today, and then Amazon, both of our $1 trillion market cap companies, they told us a lot of things today. And even then, this whole earnings season, I know I got you guys hyped up and everything. It's been kind of disappointing, but we're going to talk about that because there is some other opportunities coming next week. But more so now, even the data and what it's telling us, despite some of the results and movements being disappointing, this is giving us information. So we're going to have tomorrow being Friday, not too many earnings reports after hours. Most of them are going to happen in the morning. So tomorrow is mainly going to be a continuation day. I have the keys for you. We're going to talk about that. But I want to talk about something now with the market and where we are at, and even this whole deflation TLT bond stuff, because you're seeing something happening. Again, this was one of the best months in a long time. This was a rally. When you really put it in a perspective, we were at 220, which is crazy. That's actually really crazy. So this is a really big move up in a short amount of time, and there's something we need to look at. Again, the bond market, baby, the bond market. So let us not delay. You guys know what you need to do. Drop your thumbs up on the video. Make sure you're subscribed, and if you don't know, we are live Monday through Friday, 30 minutes before open. It's the first link in the description, and it is pinned in the comments. We better see you there in the morning. It's free 99. It costs you nothing to join. YouTube.com/thestockmarket. You can post the plays, ask questions, socialize, jokealize, hope alive. Anything. Oh, just be positive and respectful. And the most important thing you need to do, post your watch it below. Let us know what you're looking at. You got any plays, comments, remixes, anything, post them below. We need to know, source that information. Some of you, one of you guys are going to do something great. One of you going to change the world. So might as well source that. You know, let's go. But let us get to the keys right off the bat. Let me make this bigger for you. But like we said, the big names are done now for earnings. Apple, Amazon, Facebook, Google. You got a lot of the bigger, more brand names out the way. However, if you guys have watched these earnings seasons, you know some of these off-brand names, and we did get to see Western Digital today after hours. We'll go over the play that we made on that. But they moved outside of the range. They moved 13%. So some of these companies can still move. However, the big names were very disappointing to a degree. And what I'm saying that is even with Apple and Amazon today now. So if you guys want to even go look back there, here is Apple. They're even selling off, and Apple wasn't as bad as, you know, Apple's case is a little weird. They even did a buyback and dividend, but they did also cut their guidance, the outlook. That was pretty much it, but they beat, but not by much. You saw a slowdown in China, and it was still a slowdown, but, you know, they still made more money. Revenue was good, but there's still stuff about it. It's just like things are slowly declining, but the key is Q2, and I think they were a little bit off on their estimates for that. But the big one was Amazon, because now, this is what I'm saying, even though some of these companies reported, you're getting information, it's telling you about the pace of, again, the economic situation right now is very, very serious. So Amazon now, think about it. Amazon, everybody's closed. These are the guys to go to. They gave guidance, and why? Because they're engaged in business still, and I think they have a handle on it. But even then, Amazon gave guidance, and now the thing was pretty much like we've seen with China and Apple and those results. It looks like all of these companies, these big behemoths, you know, they're either beating by like $2 or $3 billion, but then they're now guiding downwards of around $3 billion. In Amazon's case, they're expecting $4.4 billion in coronavirus expenses. So they lowered their guidance. They were expected to do Q3 profits or Q2 profits at like $1.5 billion net, and they're expected anything from losing 1.5 to making 1.5, but the middle point of that is zero. So the market didn't take it too well, but these moves are pretty small, and you could kind of tell, you know, the market's reacting to that. It gives us information, but it's clear there is, you know, everybody's waiting on a broader move, and I'll show you what I'm talking about next with that. But in general, though, pay attention to the company's reporting with the guidance, what it's saying, what their industries are, their involvement with every, just the economy in general. Are they operating? Are they not operating? Are they one of the stay-at-home businesses that benefit off of it, or people would buy their services? But it's a mix of taking all this information and piecing it together. But earnings has been pretty bunk so far, but we're still going to get other moves. Now, the next thing is going to be continuations. You got Amazon and Apple, but look at the broader effect those companies will have on the market. They will affect a lot of things. And then any of the companies that reported this week, even last week, think like Netflix, they're still in this prime continuation zone. So if we get volatility, we'll see. And we've been getting data. We got the GDP data, I believe, yesterday, and it wasn't good. You got the Guild, the Remdes stuff. So again, there's a lot of things going on. When you look at the market, this is what I've talked about, where it's saying everything is kind of snowballing together to create, in a sense, one big piece of news. But now, the final thing I want to talk about is TLT and SPY. So before any plays, I mean, this is where we're saying deflation and everything else going on. I've showed you this many times. So if you're new, it looks a little, you this might be new to you, but take a look here. This is the 10-year bond. And now this is August 2019. So this was the last time we hit TLT. So the first time we did TLT 100 to like 10,000. Then the second time, you know, we did 500 to 50,000. But it all started with the bonds and what we're looking at. I mean, again, I'm a big fan of the bond market. And I've been saying this, the part that sucks about bonds is that they move really, really slow. And you guys, you know, you've seen a month of going straight up. But this is what I'm trying to point out here. Bonds were kind of following in the market or diverged. The market was going up at the time. Bonds were low. Then the Fed bonds started to drop. The market started to drop. Then things got better. And you could see, you know, picture just September 2019, ended 2019, coming into 2020, what did we see? You saw that rally. You know, you saw this big rally over here. You saw bonds go up, but then at one point during that rally, even in December, bonds started to go down. So even as the stock market continued, though, there was that divergence, and this was one of those signals that we said, pay attention to. Anytime this has happened, I always say pay attention, but it's a game of musical chairs because you never know if it's going to pop out or and the effect it's going to have. Because again, bonds, big money, moves very, very slow. It's a really, really big ship. It's a lot of sip you got there. But this is what I'm saying. In the midst of all this, you know, watch February. So this is where we hit TLT. So again, we bet against TLT. We said bond rates are going to go up. TLT shoots up. So you can see it here, March 6th. You know, let me go back here to the 100-day. And now you could kind of see where we're at right now. But, you know, pretty much near the bottom, you know, bonds started going crazy. We caught that. The bonds fell out. People rushed into those. That's why we profited. Then eventually they fixed TLT. The Fed stepped in. This is the intervention. You could see that. And then that's where, you know, even though the market kept dropping, bonds kept going with it. And then everything eventually reversed. You could even see bonds, if anything, led the market. So this is what I'm saying here now is that just take a look even now from the beginning of April, bonds just, they kind of tried to rally for, you know, the first 2 weeks, but now they've came down this last 2 weeks, we're hanging down at the low here, but now you see the market, you see the divergence again, essentially, bond yields are at where we were on like March 6th. So the SPY was around right here. So this is kind of, this might even, that's why I'm saying, putting this into context, this might be your new range or this might be your new Wuhan zone. Let's see what the bonds say. But at the end of the day, there is a divergence here. Now, this is the point I want to say. The bonds relates to deflation. We've heard the Fed. We've heard all this. You guys like some of this macro stuff. I just want you to picture these terms. When I say the term crash, pop, the bubble pops, think about that. It's like an immediate crash, boom, it's fast. Now think about the word deflating or deflation. Imagine you're sitting on an air mattress with a hole in it or it has the little thing unturned. Picture how that's going to happen. And that's what I'm viewing this as, where deflation is going to occur slowly. And it's going to be slow in pain and slow in pain, just like we're seeing here. But what is confirming that all of these earnings, because now they're not seeing a crash or a pop with any of their earnings. Even then, they're still factoring we're going to lose $3-4 billion. That's nothing. I know it's still a lot of money, but it's really nothing. But at, you know, $3-4 billion quarter after quarter after quarter. And then you don't know what's going to happen. That's the game changer, but that sounds more like deflation. So I know a lot of you guys have UUP, TLT. Just keep that in mind. I'm still looking at those plays. TLTs have got cheaper, but that's good. That's what exactly what we wanted. If the premiums die now, you bought time on a slow moving asset. So now we have a good place marker. We could see what happens with these plays, but the bonds will really, really tell us, and it's already going to go slower with the market. But essentially, I'm looking for the bond market to really lead everything here. Just because the Fed stepped in, they were able to stop it. I don't think it's fixed just yet. And well, we will find out really soon, but that is your little econ lesson. That's something with the broader theory. And even for those asking, you know, why the market's going up, even in general, this is deflation. This is what I really do believe it in a way. I know Jerome Powell would be disappointed if he heard me say this. I'm sorry, Jerome, but you switched teams in 2008-19 too, okay? I'm not going to forget that, but it's still all love. So I still love you, man. If you want to get on the show anytime, please welcome. 100 racks for a feature. But I think it's going to come off very, very slow with all of these plays. And in that process, deflation, just keep that in mind. So hope you enjoyed that. Hope that helped you. Gave you an idea even how we're going to manage some of these plays. But let us get into the plays. So right off the bat, let's go over all of the plays I made today. We didn't do too much, but I've been going after these YOLOs a little bit more with these earnings. Again, just because I wanted to take it if it was Q2. You know, I felt like for me personally, again, if you're starting out and, you know, you don't have experience with this, I mean, I don't think the same thing applies. I want to give, maybe I just fell victim to FOMO. But I'm saying, you know, this is one of those quarters where it is, you know, we're at an interesting moment. If anything, I didn't want to get caught with nothing, but I did get a little bit greedy, but I tried to do something different. And what I've been noticing is that these debit spreads have saved me a lot because they've kept me in the game. They've gotten me good plays with low risk, high reward, but now I don't have to go with some of these bigger positions to kind of force the gains that I want. But I made that AMD play today. I bought them. I got five of them at 30 cents, $150. Next week, $60 calls. But those went down 50% today. So again, this was that continuation play. They went down. So still going to hold that play till next week. I brought up the reason why with AMD, but you could see the stock, everything else that happened. We were just wrong on that completely. But there's a reason why, like I said, I put in $150. So scaling down has helped me in that instance. But now I did an Amazon put because I had those two. I had like 1,900 in calls. So those are going to get clapped. But those are till like September, I think, or something like that, or June. But I got the Amazon May 15th, 2110, 2100 debit spread, and I spent $87 each. So I spent $160 total. And somebody asked me about this play. They're like, why would you go with these debit spreads? And you could see, like, if I wanted to buy a 2100, which was like just outside of one standard deviation, it cost you like $700. That's a lot. Even if I wanted to spend like $80, again, you see the chain, it's illiquid, but it would take you somewhere like 30, 40% out of the money with, you know, two weeks of time. It's just very unrealistic. This allowed me now to get close to the money, but also, you know, not spending too much with the risk. So I said, says 215, but I spent 86. You can see the max risk is $172. If Amazon went to 2109 and it was expected priced in to go to 2200, so an extra $100, extra 5% more or less, 172 would turn into 1800. So we got that. We'll probably be up on that a little bit, but I'm not too sure. I've been surprised with some of these contracts. Then I went after the Apple Black Swan play. Again, I was expecting a big move with Apple. I got the May 8th next week. Again, debit spread. This one's three standard deviations out the money, but I like the cheap price. So I bought $200 worth. I got them at 7 cents and I bought 30 of them. But you know, why did I like that trade? I think it's like a $7,000 max reward. Yeah. Off of $180. So, or 210. I don't know why it says 180, but there's that. And then finally, Western Digital, that was the final play that we had. And we've been looking at that for earnings. But remember, I had those 10 contracts. Those went up in value and we were up on them like 180%. So I was like, well, I don't know if I wanted to buy a put. Why did I sell it too? Is that it went up into earnings, but it really wasn't making the move. And then again, the fact was I was hoping Western Digital was going to have a run up and it didn't. And you saw how the market opened. So that threw that theory right out the window. And then the premium was up. And then now you're kind of sitting there shaky. So I said, well, I'm going to take some profits. I did get to achieve some of the run up, took some money off the table. And instead I got back, you know, that's like what, $400 or so, five of these contracts at 83 cents. And then I just bought one of the next week 41 puts. And then those should be around the money. But I spent $75, but that way collect 400 back, reduce some of my exposure. I pretty much made the call play free, and then I just spent $75 on a put. So we'll see. We're still holding all the other plays. We definitely got clapped. I gave it back. You know, we made like $10,000 last week, and we gave it all right back this week. And that's because, again, some stuff lost value, like TLT, all that. But then, you know, some of these Google plays, and we didn't sell any premium. So last week, we got like $5,000 or $6,000 off of just selling premium and covering it off of these earnings. Instead, we bought the earnings and took an L, but we would have lost with the Google, but then we would have came back and one. So looks like premium selling is the winner. But besides that, as far as plays tomorrow, I think it's going to be Abivi and Guild, or I think they could have something. I'm going to watch the biotechs, and the key is with Amazon pretty much too. Amazon, Apple, even Facebook as well, any of these companies, and I'm so disappointed in what Facebook did, but they're either going to have a huge continuation, or picture this right now. You see this after hours move. This is how it is going to look throughout the whole day. So picture in the morning, it's going to open, sell off really quickly. You won't be able to make a play. It'll make one quick move for like 5-10 minutes, come down, kind of bounce up for like 30 minutes, hour, come down, look like the action's going to happen, bounce up. You're going to get confused, angry, pissed. You're still trading the weeklies, and it's just going to be a giant cuck. You can see, expect this tomorrow. That's one scenario. Or it is just going to be a straight up, like you saw with like ServiceNow. So again, ServiceNow was a continuation 2 days in a row. So again, ServiceNow after the day before the earnings, it went like this, ran up, Think about that. That's 30 minutes. Most of the move is captured. The second half of the move, the next 30 minutes. Then that next day after a positive earnings, gaps up, and then, you know, check the timing on there. Within 15 minutes, it made the first move. Within 30 minutes or an hour, it's already made the biggest move, and then it kind of holds a range from there. That would be a continuation. So those are going to be your two scenarios with any of the continuations, but you want something like this, and something like this will be the best case scenario. This is going to be 50-50, but depending on how the market is, depending on how things move, it could offer an opportunity to flip these in the morning. So I'm going to be watching all those plays. I'm still in those service now, and again, we did that strangle on them yesterday, and that earnings play did win, but it wasn't, you know, to the extent I really like too much. We spent $230 on that play for both ways, $110 on the put, $110 on the call. And again, watch service now to continue because they're killing it. But we spent $230 total. I'm up $370. Pretty much I'm lost 62% on the June put, but then made 400% on the call. But the net total profit unrealized right now is $160. So still holding those. That's a decent continuation. I'm going to be watching that. Same thing with Facebook. At least Facebook held up a little bit. Oh, man. See, after hours, and you could already kind of see the effect here. I mean, after hours could be ugly here with Apple coming down and everything. Because again, oh, yep. Those are going to be your bigger market cap companies. Again, both trillion-dollar behemoths.
What if they lose that status?
So again, this could get in the way of continuations, or if Apple and Amazon move hard, it's going to have an effect on that. However, this morning, you saw some weird diver. You saw Apple and Boeing and other companies lead this morning. Watch out for, you know, really call out the ones that are lagging and leading, because again, this cat dog and that divergence, that push-pull, it's going to be very important. It's telling us something, but again, I'm looking for the broader push-pull between the market. But watch Facebook, still holding that play. The weeklies got clapped. Amazon, we're going to see that, like we said, and then AMD, I still like the play. I mean, it just literally got crushed again, another 4%. So we got stuck in the middle, took a high risk, high reward trying to get it early in the morning. Again, you see what I'm talking about with some of these moves. You're taking that risk if you buy it in the morning. You have higher risk, high reward in the morning. If you want more stability with your prices and don't want them to fluctuate, you get them in the middle of the day or towards the end of the day. And then watch Boeing. They were interesting. I mean, they've been on a roll, but the factor in this range, I don't like it, man. I think it's very suspicious and looks like a borderline company about to announce bankruptcy. I don't know. I don't want to put that out there. We'll see, though, but this is sketchy. And their debt did rise a lot, but watch them. Watch Western Digital. Again, this was a surpriser. This one finally, this was a clap. So we have those 41s. That would be good. And then watch them in the morning because Western Digital is not expected to move a lot. So 13% is big for them. And then tomorrow in the morning, those weekly contracts will even be cheap. So I definitely want WDC for the continuation. Same thing with Snap. I still didn't roll over that play. I want to, but watch what they do here, because if they start to give up and can't break above 18, you guys remember what happened. Which earnings was it? Man, we've been Snap holders for so long. It might look something like this. Again, it was the same exact thing at 18, except this has just been a more violent move, but it does mimic this move a lot. So I'm hoping this plays out so I could collect that premium, and we'll see. But still watch them. If they do make a break above 18, understand that, you know, that level is important for them. Then Abivi has earnings. I like them. I'm excited to see what they report, but it could be pivotal, and they might be one that, depending on their earnings, if they do surprise, it's going to be in the morning. But the contracts on Abivi will be weird. Again, it's not expected to move a lot in the short term, but it is a biotech, so there could be some good short-term flips on that. Then Gilead, they reported, they went up, and again, a bunch of news on Gilead today. This back and forth, even with the China and leak stuff. I still believe it. I'm still holding the plays. They're going to fluctuate. We got a lot of time. If anything, talk to me when they're down 70-80%, and I'll see if I want more. But I still like the whole Guild logic and thesis. Then UNH, I think, is going to be great tomorrow. They led the market. You could even tell right now, you know, they shot up in the morning. They held up. They looked really good for no reason. So let's see. But remember, there was Cigna and all that. But even in the midst of the earnings, they've held up very, very nice. And I like that. So this even just looks like a chart. You could even tell on this 100-day. It's not like it's breaking out and doing what some of those tech stocks are doing, but it looks kind of like Lysol did early stages, but it could move pretty much. I like Lysol, I meant Clorox, but them, Apple, and then finally TLT. I want to see TLT. UUP, not quite yet, but TLT, the prices are cheap. I know I could be slow, but I'm down like $3,200 on that $5,000 position, but we will see. But I like a lot. I like me some TLT, you know what I'm saying? But that is your watch list, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you hydrate, healthy, ready to go. Make sure you post your watch list. Make sure we see you there in the morning. I need the armor on. I need the helmet shining. I need you in the game. Don't get disappointed. I don't care if you made money, lost money. You're going to learn something, baby. You need to create. Don't be timid. Don't let a setback hold you back. And I guess we're going to change the world, baby. I'm telling y'all, you need to think. Think outside the box. And at the same time, we need to balance it. The long-term portfolios, space it out, set the budget. We still got opportunity. And remember, what you made today, The opportunity you missed is setting you up for the one you want. And the opportunity you got is so you avoid the other. It's all a learning lesson, baby. But I'm excited. Earnings has disappointed, but it's going to come back. The cult loves you. I love you. Let's go.